just a couple of things. At the time, thank you for staying away from the license committees, but people in the Republicans now betray this is happening down the south. Someone Manning has said that they're worried about the whole situation of John Cross. And then one goes there at night time, there's no one there. The pubs are empty. They're empty. And then what do you depend on the daytime coming now? And then come 5 or 6 o'clock, they move on. So I'm not surprised now that no one's getting come forward. But I'd like to take the opportunity as well to thank all the officers and all members of the committee that have recommitted in the last several years. Everyone, single person that was staying away, and we've had some hard cases and spent some long hours and doing some of the cases and had marvelous support from the police as well. So any more questions on that? Any more questions? Any questions? No? Okay then, thank you.
I'll move the recommendation to move forward.
And can you second that? Okay,
agreed?
Okay. Now, just there's a couple of things about the business, but I only to take a few minutes before we run out of time before the elections. What I think we should be doing, I've spoken to various people about this, I think we should be doing some initiatives ourselves. We sit in a committee and we talk about various areas of pubs, and we have the figures. I mean, it probably goes into the other committees coming up. But I think, like the alcohol units, I think we should go and visit that. But if that comes up all the time, the figures and what's happening with alcohol-related problems, I think we should book at like a new client with the emergence of licensed premises. And then maybe we should look at other areas that are not so vibrant. And I know there's areas in the West Gate and Oil again that's up and coming, the one, and maybe we should do stuff like that. Because we sit around the offices, we talk for long hours about all of licensed premises, licensed strategies, and I've spoken to Martin about this, and would you agree that we be a little bit more proactive and do some stuff like that? Ali?
Well, yeah, I agree, and we spoke about it before, the committee opened. Really good idea, but I also think we should invite staff members as well, clerks to the committee and people like that, because if we talk about them, they're sitting there in a vacuum. It's better if they get some first-hand evidence as well, so we should also invite clerks or staff.
No, Chair, that's fine. What I'll do is I'll start making some arrangements. And my understanding, what we've been seeking to do, one of the areas where there has been a gap is that we did have quite an effective pub watch on Wirral, and due to costs and staffing, etc., that there has been some sort of, if you like, a lull in that. We have been in discussions with the Chamber of Commerce, and therefore, that would have been a forum where, members could have come along and spoke with licensees, etc. But we are looking to have some separate meetings with licensees. We've already identified that we wanted to have a meeting with those in New Brighton. The Chamber did want to be involved in this type of work as well. Our next meeting, I've got to say that we're seeking to plan with licensees. Won't be surprised to you, but it's in connection with the Open Championship. I can advise members of when that meeting will be, but we're looking to get a venue and set a date. It'll be early evening, just to answer any questions that they have, but also emphasise to you the high standards that we expect to be operating at all times. But also to obviously offer any assistance should they need it in the run-up to the Open Championship coming to Wirral.
Member, do you want to go to that meeting? So, are you interested in that meeting? I've got the indication that
you're
there. So, I've there any other business? Thanks for your attendance, and those who's on the next committee, remain.